This is a bit of a departure from what I usually do here. As some of you know, I'm a proud member of the Sigma Phi Epsilon fraternity, more commonly known as SigEp. What you may not know is that I also credit SigEp with turning me into the person that I am today. Yeah, this is totally their fault. If you're looking for a funny video, you can shut this one off and come back tomorrow. But if you want to learn a little bit more about how I got where I am today, this video will help explain it.
Why did I join SigEp?
That's a good question, and it's not one I can be funny about. I joined, and you're like, boo, we wanted you to be a dick about it. Honestly, I joined SigEp as an accident. No, I mean, that's true, I think, for a lot of people in this room. I think a lot of us did not intend to. I was a writer for the paper, and the news editor was a SigEp, and he had a staff party at the house. And so, you know, it was only like 10 of us, so we all went over to the house, and he was showing me around, and I was like, oh, this is a really nice house. And he goes, well, you know, meetings are Sundays at 9, and my exact words were, you can go fuck yourself, because I didn't think I would ever join. And he made me promise, we were close, and he made me promise to come to one meeting. And I did. And I was there for 5 minutes before I wanted to join. Because I looked around that room, and I realized that these were the people I had been looking for the last year on campus. Like, these were the people I wanted to be friends with, who I admired, and they were funny, and they were interesting, and they had confidence, some of them a little too much. You know, they had confidence, and it was just, I realized, I looked around that room, and I said, this is what I want to be. And I rushed, and I was bid 2 weeks later, and I joined. And I got real lucky, I think, joining SigEp, because I had no concept of the national fraternity when I joined. And I didn't realize that we were the first national fraternity to ban racial discrimination. I didn't know that about us when I joined. It's just something I found out later. And then, when I was at my first conclave, we became the first one of our peers to officially put that we do not discriminate based on sexual orientation. And that's something that I was unaware of was going to happen when I joined. And I feel like I was very lucky that I happened to join a national organization that I respect so much, just because I wanted to hang out with about 20 guys at Columbia. So. This is my 9th conclave. I believe it is my 5th one in a row where I'm doing a show, and it is something that I look forward to every 2 years. It's a ton of fun. And the reason is simple. It's not because I know it's a great crowd every time, which it is. It's not because I sell a fuck ton of albums, which I do. The reason I look forward to it is because, like I was trying to explain before, SigEp was an accident for me. It's something that I had no idea what it all meant, and I joined a very young chapter. It was I was one of the founding fathers of our chapter, and I was about 20 guys in, and by the time we got our charter a year later, we had 45, and I was chapter president. And thanks, one guy. And I and that summer, the president of our alumni board sat me down and asked me if I was going to go to Chicago for conclave. And I told him I didn't know what that meant. I mean, I knew what the fuck Chicago was, but and he told me that he thought it was very important for me to go, and that the alumni board would cover the travel completely, and make sure that anything that I didn't get covered for being the delegate, the shortfall would be covered by the alumni board. And so with that, I was like, free trip to Chicago, I'm fucking going. And I went, and it changed my life completely. That first time when I looked around the room at the chapter house, I realized who I wanted to be. And then when I looked around the room here, I realized I was wrong, because I had set a very low ceiling for myself the first time. I realized what was possible when I looked around and I saw brothers from all over the country from, I saw alumni who had been committed to this organization for 70 years. And it was so amazingly inspiring, especially because at that time, I was not a comedian. I could barely speak publicly at that time. I was a very shy, very introverted kid. And first, the chapter believed in me, and then the national organization believed in me. And so the reason I love coming here so much, and I love doing these shows, is because your undergraduate years are wonderful, but they're a blip. They will last 4 years, maybe five, maybe six if you're a fucking idiot. But they will last a short time compared to the rest of your life. And I love coming to Conclave because I love seeing so many of you realize what I realized almost 20 years ago, which is to set the ceiling higher. And I've been trying to do that ever since. I said it yesterday, I will say it many more times, but again, it's great to be a SigEp. Have a good night.
I know it wasn't comedy, but I hope you enjoyed it anyway. Thanks for subscribing and clicking that little bell. And if you're an incoming college student who has any questions about SigEp, I'm happy to answer all of them. You can email me at fans@stevehofstetter.com.